Hey Sandy, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good, how was your drive in?
It was good, it was a little long.
It was long?
Yeah.
Yeah? And having a good week?
I've been having a great week, yeah.
Yeah? What have you been up to this week?
Not much, just taking care of the kids.
Yeah? And what are your kids' names again?
Bobby Joe and Louise.
Those are some beautiful names.
I know, they're pretty fantastic.
Yeah? And they're, how old are they?
They're 4 and 6.
4 and 6, wow, well, that's a handful.
Yeah, there's lots.
Crazy 4-year-olds.
Yeah.
I'm sure the 6-year-old. And then, do they fight?
No, yeah, they're okay. They're actually not bad.
That's good, that's good. What are you doing other than just taking care of them these days? Working or?
I work as I'm actually a teacher.
Oh, yeah?
So I have quite a demanding schedule, yeah.
Yeah, so how's work been going?
It's going good, yep.
Yeah?
Going good.
So, having came in today, we have just a few things to go over. We did the barbecue and everything last week, if you remember, and
yeah.
That went really well. And it seems like you're ready for a change. Is there anything you want to talk about, like anything that you feel like you want to improve or change?
Well, I really want to get rid of my baby weight. I'd like to lose 15 pounds, get back to
yeah.
the weight I was before my kids.
Yeah, and what's your like daily schedule? What's your day like on a day-to-day basis?
I wake up, make my kids breakfast. Sometimes I don't have time for my own breakfast, or sometimes, you know, I'll go through McDonald's.
Yeah, lots of fast
food. Drop them off to school. Yeah, I don't have much time, so.
And for lunch, are you eating fast food certainly too?
Sometimes.
Yeah. What do you make your kids for breakfast?
I usually make them just a bowl of cereal, maybe some toast.
Yeah, so.
But often I don't have time to eat, so.
Yeah, so you have to try and find something that you can take on the road. Have you ever done any meal prep kind of things?
No, never.
No, do you know what meal prep is? You know, preparing the night before or preparing, you know, you can prepare meals through the week for Sunday, have meals ready throughout the week and then take them to go and everything. So separate containers and everything. Would you be interested in trying that?
Yeah, that could work. Yeah, yeah, if
that's one thing you can do, start doing. And you know, those fast foods, you're not trying to stay away from those because they've got lots of fat, not good for you, not good for your health, your arteries.
Yeah.
Want to change that.
I just never have any time.
Yeah, no, time is of the essence, of course. And I totally get with busy schedule and kids and everything. Maybe when your kids go to sleep, I'm sure they go to sleep regularly.
Yeah.
You can maybe try to prep then, and you know, you can spend time with your husband and maybe do it together. Start meal prepping together, taking the same meals. It can be a bit competitive, but it's actually a good way to eat, get healthy foods and everything. So we did the past BQ questionnaire. So it seems like you're not working out that much, but you do enjoy your yoga.
Yeah, I really enjoyed yoga when I was pregnant with my kid. I really enjoyed those classes.
Yeah. And so how did you stop going? Did you just...
It was prenatal yoga, so it was
yeah.
kind of... I don't know. I don't really know if there's facilities around. I'm not
yeah,
sure.
No, there's lots of facilities in the area. They offer all different types of yoga. I don't know if you've heard of hot yoga. That seems to be a big one, really. And then there's all sorts of Pilates and similar classes that you can take. That's something that you want to get started into and you want to try. You can sign up, try a couple of classes a week and get into that and everything. Yeah, do you feel comfortable about that?
Yeah, I could look into that.
Yeah, and in terms of time, how do you think you could manage fitting in these things into your daily schedule?
I'm not sure. I don't really, you know, I'm kind of afraid of how much money a gym membership costs.
Yeah, for sure. Well,
so
any
way you can do stuff not at the gym.
Yeah, there's definitely yoga is one of the greatest things and easiest things to do at home. You just need to get a yoga mat, and you can actually buy DVDs that have great classes on them and do everything from home. So that way you're still at home with your family, but you're also getting to get that workout in as well. Another thing, you know, what's your commute like to work? Like how do you get to work?
I live pretty close to my work.
Yeah, and do you drive?
I do always drive.
Yeah, okay, well there's something we can change. I know in the winter months it's a little bit harder, but have you ever tried cycling to work or even...
No, I don't have a bike.
Is it, how long's the walk for?
Maybe, it's probably about a 15 minute walk.
Yeah, so maybe start trying to walk to work. You don't have to start every day, but you know, work it in, start a couple times one week and keep adding a day as you go. Just like, you know, when you explain it's hard for you to quit smoking, you have to cut back.
Yeah.
Well, instead of cutting back, we're gonna add in. You're going to add in one day walking to work a week. And then, in terms of cutting back, you're going to cut back those fast foods and try not eat as many.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is a great start. We're going to get started on this program with you.
No, that seems like everything I came for.
Yeah, if you feel you're ever overwhelmed with time, you just need to remember that if this is something you want in life and you want to change, you just cut out a little bit of time. Like even those 15 minutes walking to and from work, that's some good exercise that you're getting every day.
Okay.
Okay, thanks for coming in.
Thank you. Thank you for everything.
Kind of maybe weight maintenance.
Yeah.
Just trying to maintain weight instead of gain any weight, but definitely you don't want to lose too much weight at this point. But, if you're okay with that, you can try to change some of those things. With the eating and nutrition, kind of out of my scope, so I just want to refer you to a guy who's a dietitian, registered dietitian. So if you're willing to discuss with him about your diet.
Yeah, and some eating disorders in the past, so I definitely need help there.
Yeah, that'd be a good idea, and so I can give you his information and give him a call. So yeah, that's good. So.
Yeah, thanks so much for all
the
help.
Thanks a lot for coming in. Okay,
thanks.
Good to see you again. How did you do at your last event there?
I did pretty good.
Yeah? You had a good time?
Yeah.
Is it a personal best?
Not a personal best.
Oh, my idea. So how did you get into track? I've just never really met someone that's been in track.
My older brother was in it, so I just kind of always stuff. So.
Did you play other sports and stuff growing up too?
Yeah, I did some of the first year.
Oh, yeah.
Played basketball. I was really good.
Well, it clearly shows. It shows in all the results. Do you remember some of the tests we did last week?
Yeah.
You remember that we did like the VO2 and the strength testing and stuff. So you're obviously athletic. You obviously know that. You killed all the results. I have your physical activity questionnaire from last week. Obviously, you work out enough. You don't do much time spending around computers and TVs and stuff. So there's not too much to change on that aspect. So if you can see on your list here, your VO2 is in the excellent category, your overall strength, your endurance, you did push-ups over the total, so everything's really good. I'm just wondering, what sort of things do you do on your time outside of class?
Outside of class, I just try to play games and just hang out.
Yeah, how's your diet? How are you eating?
Pretty good. I eat quite a bit.
Yeah, would you consider, on a scale of 1 to 10, would you consider it with 0 being like super clean and vegetarian and 10 being fast food every day? What would you?
It's definitely a clean diet, so it'd be closer to 0. You all have like not fast food, but it'll like maybe once a week. So it's very clean diet.
And you said you don't smoke, do you drink at all?
I don't drink very often, but when I do, it's maybe on the weekend and it'll be like going out with my friends. So. You have quite a few on those
nights. Yeah. How many would you say? Would you say it was a casual night of like 3 or less, or would you say more?
More than half, probably close to
the. Well, more than that?
Yeah, probably close to 10 or 12 drinks in a row, you know, like just one after the other.
Now, do you find that affects your workouts the next day?
Yeah, I feel a little bit hungover.
Yeah, so I mean, that's an easy change. I would say maybe during the season, try to limit your food drinking a little bit. That'd be the first obvious thing. And do you keep track of your workouts at all, or?
I don't. No,
you don't? Because I noticed that your goal setting here, you have nationals coming up pretty soon, right?
Yes, I do.
So you got your long-term goal here as trying to place at nationals.
Yes.
So you want to improve. But you don't keep track of your workouts or anything like that?
No.
So that'd be a good start for us. Right now, I know you're on your fitness program through the school, but so basically, because you're so athletic and you have the foundation for what we're going to build to, we're going to do more